I welcome you all in this session. Topic of this section is the subsector of agriculture, and you are all know that the agriculture is a broad sector comprising various subsectors like horticulture sector, the livestock sector, the fishery sectors, the beekeeping, sericulture. There are many different subsectors which are contributing in the agriculture sectors, they are contributing in the agriculture GDP, and we have observed that over the period of time the share of agriculture sector is declining in the national GDP, in the national economy, but the share of this subsector, they are contributing, their share is increasing over the period of time in the agriculture sector. So basically today we will be learning about different subsectors who comprise the agriculture sector as a whole, and you know, what are their significance. We are going to discuss the significance of the different subsectors in the agriculture sectors, particularly the horticulture sector, the livestock sectors, and what are the different policy actions which are required for promotion of this sector, so that we have overall economic development, overall agriculture development in the country. So we are going to discuss about different subsectors of the agriculture sectors. Let us first understand what are the different subsector in agriculture. I know agriculture is comprised of several subsectors like horticulture sector, livestock sector, the poultry sector, fishery sector, agroforestry is also there. So these are the different major subsectors. There are many others are also there, but these are the major sectors which are contributing in the agriculture sectors. Basically these sectors importance we can understand, they are the large employment providing sector. They are the basically business organization. You know, crops, actually we have the purpose to have the food, but these are the sectors, these are the subsectors which directly contribute in their livelihood. They provide the more income generating activity for them. And now we'll move one by one in the different subsectors. Like horticulture sectors is also a very big sector. So we have different types of the crops in the horticulture sectors. Like we have the fruit crops, we have the vegetable crops, like we have the ornamental crops, the flowers, floriculture is there, medicinal and aromatic plants are there, the spices crops are there, like black pepper, cardamom, these are the spices crops there. Then we have the plantation crops like tea, coffee, rubber, coconut. These are the different plantation crops which are, you know, highly, you know, foreign exchange earning crops. We are doing lot of, you know, export of this crops. Those horticulture crops in contribution is for the providing the nutritional security as well as to earn the foreign exchange by exporting these horticulture crops. Then in the livestock sector, which is very broad sector, like is basically involved in the production of the milk, dairy and meat products, and then from livestock also we get some wool that are also contributing a lot. Then we also get the byproducts from livestock like hides and skins. Then poultry farming is very good and one of the very good enterprises, like from the poultry we get the eggs and chicken meat. Then from the agroforestry we get the wood and the other forest based product, minor forest product. Then fisheries also, you know, we have the fish, shrimps and other seafood products, which there are, you know, lot of have importance for the export earning, for income generation activity in the country, in the agriculture sector. Now understand the importance of the subsector in the agriculture. Like, you know, we have the different subsector, they occupy a significant place in the agriculture economy of the India, and the overall contribution of agriculture in the total GDP has, you know, drastically declined. You know, we were having the around 50% contribution in the national GDP in the 1950s. Now we have around 16.5%. So there is a drastic decline in the contribution of the agriculture sector in the national GDP. Then, but the contribution of these subsectors, like, you know, horticulture, livestock, it is increasing the total agricultural GDP. We will also see some data about this. Then, but there is one important things which we should mention, that there is the product from these subsectors like horticulture sector, the livestock sector, they are in the perishable natures, you know. Therefore, we need to have effective marketing linkage between the producer and the final consumers, because they are the perishable commodities, so we cannot store for much period of time. So we need to provide the effective marketing system for the to get the money out of the horticulture and livestock business. And you know, now move to the horticulture subsectors. Let us understand the significance of the horticulture subsectors. It is contributing, it is generating, it is increasing the income of the agriculture sectors through the by increasing the productivity, then providing the employment, and also we are getting the foreign exchange. We are doing increasing export of the horticulture commodities, horticulture produce, and you know, this horticulture community had contributed a lot, and it has moved the rural society, rural community from the rural confines to the commercial venture. So actually purpose of the horticulture commodity is, or horticulture produce, you get the daily earning. You know, in case of the crops like rice or wheat, we get the production in once or twice in a year, but in case of the horticulture crops, we have the opportunity to get the earning daily, and after by selling the fruits and vegetables, and the basically fruits are vegetables, you know, they are the short duration crops, so that's why they provide the more regular income to the farmers who are doing. So scenario of the horticulture sector is encouraging in the country. You know, the percentage share of the horticulture output in agriculture has become around 33%. So 33% contribution from the horticulture sectors, and you know, the government is also focusing on the development of horticulture sectors by increasing the planned outlay in the horticulture sector. Like in the 11th 5-year plan, there were 3.9% outlay was given for the agriculture, the horticulture sector. That has been increased to 4.6% during the 11th during the 12th plan of total agriculture sector. So out of the total plant outlay for the agriculture sector, the share of the horticulture sector is increasing over the period of time. Then you know, the we have seen that there is an increase in the horticulture production due to two reasons. One is the area expansion, so area is also increasing in the horticulture sectors. You know, the area under horticulture sector has grew by 2.6% per annum, and the production has increased by the 4.8% in the last decade. So the production of horticulture crops is now 312 million tons in the year 2018-19, and the area under horticulture sector is the 25.43 million hectares. So we have seen that the area and production and productivity of the horticulture sector is increasing over the period of time. Then you know, the vegetable production is also increasing over the period of time. So in the year 2004-05, we have the vegetable production of 101 million tons, and which has increased to 184 million tons in the year 2017-18, and the fruit production also increasing over the period of time. In 2004-05, we were having the fruit production of the 51 million tons, then that has increased to 97 million tons in the year 2017-18, and the total horticulture production, actually major contributing states are the Uttar Pradesh, you know, which is producing the 392 lakh tons of the horticulture production. Then West Bengal is the second largest contributor in the horticulture production, like 324 lakh tons production of horticulture commodity from the West Bengal states. Then in there are few major states which are contributing more in the horticulture production, like Uttar Pradesh, the West Bengal, the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, and Karnataka, Bihar, Tamil Nadu, Odisha, and these are the major states who are contributing a lot in the horticulture production. Then in case of the fruit production, the Andhra is the maximum, the largest producer of the horticulture commodity in the country, which is contributing around 15.6%. Then Maharashtra is contributing 12%, Uttar Pradesh is contributing 10.8%, the Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Bihar, and West Bengal, Chhattisgarh is also there. These are the major producing states, fruits producing states in the country, which are contributing a lot in the fruit production. Then total, in the total horticulture production, the fruits production share is the 31%, the vegetable production share is 59%. So maximum production, around 60% of the horticulture production is from the vegetables and the flower aromatics, they are contributing 1.2%. The plantation crops, which are highly commercial crops, which are the foreign exchange earning crops, which are contributing 5.8%. Then spices crops are also contributing 2.6% in the total horticultural production. Then Uttar Pradesh, in case of vegetable production, the Uttar Pradesh is the maximum or largest producing states in the country, and which is contributing around 15.45% of total vegetable production. Then West Bengal is also contributing around 15% in the vegetable production, and Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Odisha, Karnataka, Haryana and Chhattisgarh, these are the major vegetable producing state in the country. And when we talk about the infrastructure availability in the horticulture sector, basically, you know, we need to provide the horticulture commodity art, basically the commercial activity. So we need to provide them the all infrastructure for backward and forward linkages. Backward linkage means required seeds or the good quality seeds, the inputs and pesticides and everything, actually farm machineries. And for forward linkage, we need to provide the market yards, the cold storage. So we need to maintain the complete supply chain in case of the horticulture commodities. And actually, we are observing there is a volatility in the horticulture prices. You know, there are two reasons. One is that there is an imperfect coordination between the supply and the demand, and there is a seasonability in perishable nature of the horticulture crops. Both are from this region, there are volatility in the horticulture produce, actually. And we find that when the season, the harvest season is there in case of horticulture crops, there is a glut in the market, and you know, the demand is not matching with the supply. That's why there is a fall in the prices of the horticulture commodities. So to tackle this situation, we need to create the storage. We need to create and cold storage, which help in the marketing of the horticulture produce. So there is a focus is there on the developing or creating the cold storage in the country. Like in Uttar Pradesh, we have the 2,668 cold storage, and then in the Gujarat we have the 890 states. And in the Punjab state, we have the 670 cold storage. So, you know, there is a focus is there from the National Horticulture Board, and that the national, the horticulture missions, the cold storage are being established in the country. The purpose is to maintain or to help the farmers in the marketing of the horticulture produce, which are in basically of and the perishable nature. Then also we should talk about the consumption pattern of the horticulture. It is found that there is an increasing nutritional intake from the fruits and vegetable in the urban area than that of the rural population, because you know we have observed there is a more of the horticultural commodity fruits and vegetable consumption in the urban area than the rural area. And actually in the urban area we have also found there is a calorie intake from this fruits and vegetable is also increasing over the period of times. They are moving from the cereals to the fruits and vegetables. The per capita allowable to fruits, which is now 208 grams per day, which is against the recommended quantity of 230 grams per day per capita. So there is a scope to increase the agriculture production actually of the fruits crops, because we have the required food availability is less than the recommended dose per capita. So there is a scope to increase the horticultural production in the country. And now let us see the world scenario of the horticultural production. You know, India is the second largest producer of the fruits and vegetable in the world, and you know, we are exporting different types of horticulture commodity, particularly the grapes, which you know we are exporting to different countries, and the export of grapes is, you know, 188,000 tons, and the value of this export of the grapes is 189,995 lakhs of value of the grapes we are exporting, and the quantity is 188.5 2000 tons we are exporting the grapes, then banana and mango are other important crops we are exporting, then fresh vegetables like onion, peas and potato we are exporting. There are plantation crops like, you know, the tea, coffee, the rubber, cashew, which these are the commodities we are exporting. They are contributing in the foreign exchanging and actually also in the horticultural earning. They are contributing, they are providing employment in the horticulture sectors, in the agriculture sectors. And now here in this slide you can see the percentage share of the horticultural output in the agriculture sector. So over the period of time you will see the share of horticulture sector is increasing in the agriculture sectors. Like the total fruits and vegetable share was, you know, 22.3% in the year 2011-12, which has increased to 55.9% in the 2015-16, and the total floriculture sector, the contribution has increased from 1.5% in the year 2011-12 to 1.6% in the year 2015-16. And when we talk about the total horticulture sector's contribution in the total agriculture output, which has increased from the 29.2% in the year 2011-12 to 33.3% in the year 2015-16. So there is a lot of jump, you know, there is a continuous increase, increasing share from the horticulture sector in the agriculture output. So this is very good signs that the production and the income of the horticulture sector, the productivity of the horticulture sector, the value of the horticulture sector is increasing, and people also, the consumer also want more consumption of the fruits and vegetables. So this is very good sign for the horticulture subsector. Then how to strengthen the horticulture sector? This is very important because we are discussing about the different policy actions. So what are the policy actions can be taken up to increase the horticulture sector, to strengthen the horticulture sector? So we need to have policy support actually to increase the, to develop the marketing, the insurance and storage facilities in the horticulture sector. Actually we need to encourage the farmers to do more of the horticulture production. They need to diversify their cropping pattern from the cereal and pulses to the fruits and vegetables so they can earn more. And then there is also need to have investment in the cold chain. There is also need to have the investment in the road development, power generation and marketing infrastructure in order to also the contract farming we need to encourage in the case of horticulture sector. Actually the contract farming attracts the investor to stabilize their production and marketing linkage. So we need to develop the production and marketing linkages by promoting the contract farming in the horticulture sector. And then we need to provide all the necessary inputs and extension activity and other advices to the farmers in undertaking the horticulture production, their marketing of the produce, in purchasing of the required produce. So we need to advise, we need to provide all kind of support to strengthen the horticulture sectors. Now we'll move to the livestock sector, and you know livestock is another most important subsector of the agriculture sectors, and you know the significance of livestock sector is increasing over the period of time. Actually livestock sectors occupy a dominant place in the Indian agriculture economy because the contribution of the livestock sector is increasing in income generation activity, in employment generation activity, as well as in also the foreign exchange earning. This contribution of livestock sector is increasing over the period of time, and it is the most important food for the, you know, large section in the majority of people, and it is a basically nutritious food which provides the protein, vitamin, the calorie. So everything is there in the milk and so or meat. So the whole livestock sector is very important from the point of the food, income and employment. And this livestock sector subsector is called as a store of the wealth for the farmers because it provides many things to the farmers. It provides the drought power, it provides the organic fertilizer for the crop production, it also provides a means of transport for them. So it is this sector is called as a wealth of the farmers, and it is contributing almost 25% of the total agricultural GDP, agriculture sector production. So this is
this contribution from the horticulture, this life from the livestock sector is going to increase. It is expected the contribution of the livestock sector will be increasing due to market oriented policies, and after the particularly after trade liberalization, the contribution of the this livestock sector will be increasing over the period of time. And India is the largest milk producer in the world, so we have the maximum production of the milk in the country, in the world. Then we have also seen there is expectable growth in the consumption of the livestock products. There are 3-4 major reasons. One is the there is urbanization, so more of the people in the urbanization area, they have the good income compared to the rural area. They have money to spend on the nutritious food, so that's why demand from the urban area is coming up. Another is the population growth. Population also increasing. So if there are more people in the country to serve, so there will be more demand for the food items. So milk is one of the good food items. So there is a demand for milk is increasing over the period of time. Then convergence of food habits. So we have found there is a change in the food habit. There is a change in the consumption pattern. So there is a more of demand from the animal products, milk and milk based products, the meat, chicken. So all these products demand is there. There is a shift in the consumption pattern, and there is an income increase, per capita income is increasing over the period of time. So they have the money, people are have them, they are having the money to spend on the nutritious foods. And this significance of the horticulture sector, we have the possibility to further improve by increasing the India competitiveness, particularly when we talk about the export earning from the milk sectors or from the meat sectors. And there is a further possibility to improve the competitiveness of the India. And there are 2-3 things we need to have, actually in the world we need to have. The developed country basically, they need to reduce their support for the they are providing in the domestic support, they are providing the in their country through as a domestic support. So if developed countries they reduce their support, if they reduce their domestic support, our export competitiveness will increase. And our country need to provide some export subsidies also, and the foreign country, they need to reduce their export subsidies in the milk sector, in the livestock sector. And also if the developed country, they allow the market access, market access to our countries, if in such condition the share of the livestock sector or the foreign exchange earning from the livestock sector will increase over the period of time. And we have the very promising prospects in the livestock sector in the India due to existence of immense potential to enhance the production, consumption and export, especially the meat and dairy products, and need to enhance the competitiveness in the world market. This competitiveness is dependent mainly on the two factors. One is the price factor, another is the product quality or international standards. Actually, we need to produce the product in the horticulture sector or in the livestock sector, which is as per the standard, international standards. So we need to produce the quality produce. And the price competitiveness of the livestock sector is depend basically on the productivity and also the production cost. So we need to increase our productivity and we need to reduce our production cost. So India has huge livestock population actually, and the productivity is very low. And when we talk about the productivity comparison from the different country, developed country and developing country, our productivity is low. And though there is an average yield of the milk per animal is increasing over the period of time, but there is a great scope to further increase the productivity of the animals. And yield of bovine meat and poultry meat is also low compared to other countries, particularly from the USA, our productivity is low. And actually we need to significantly augment the productivity of the livestock in the country. And when we talk about the quality of the livestock product, actually most important determinants of demand is the quality. So we need to improve the quality of the livestock products, and consumer basically they have become more quality conscious, they become aware now. So they always see whether we are purchasing the quality product or not. So consumer become a quality conscious now, and demand only those product which have the quality. So dairy and meat products which are safe and there which are harmless to their health, they will demand actually, and actually for that purpose we need to have effective regulatory system. We need to ensure basically quality of the international standards, and by fulfilling the SPSS measures, sanitary and phytosanitary management, and technical barrier to trade requirements. So all this standard, international standard, we need to satisfy while producing the livestock sector. And in India, basically Food Safety and Standard Authority of India, they are working, they are developing standards for the production of the agricultural commodities. And here we can see some information, some data about the growth of the milk sector, livestock sector. Actually, we have the 187.75 million ton production of the milk in the country, and you know the growth of this milk production is increasing every year. So in the last year, in the we have seen the 6.5% growth in the milk production over the previous years, and the per capita availability of the milk is 394 gram per day, and you know the average yield of the animals per day is also increasing over the period of time. In case of the exotic or crossbreed, the yield or the production of per animals per day is 7.95 kg, and the growth in case of the exotic and the crossbreed yield is 8.7% over the previous years. Then in case of the indigenous and non-descript animals, the yield is 3.01 kg per animal per day, and the growth is 5.7% over the previous years. And so in India, you know, almost all the states they are producing the yield, but the major milk producing states are the Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and the Gujarat. Or these five states basically they are contributing altogether 53.1% in the milk productions. And so all the states basically they are doing the production of milk and egg production. In case of egg production, we have 103 billion egg production in the country in the year 2018-19, and the growth over the previous is 8.5% in the egg production, and the per capita availability of egg in the country is 79 gram per annum, 79 eggs per annum. And the top five producing states in India are the Andhra Pradesh, which is contributing 19%, the Tamil Nadu, which is contributing 18%, the Telangana, which is contributing 13%, West Bengal, which is contributing 8%, Haryana, which is contributing 6%. So altogether, these five states, they are contributing 65% of the total egg production in the country. And you know, there are two types of poultry we can say which are available, the commercial poultry and other is the backyard poultry. So you know, commercial poultry, they are contributing 82% of total egg production in the country, and the backyard poultry, they are contributing around 18% of the total egg production in the country. And in case of the meat production, we have 8.11 million ton production in the country, and the growth in the meat production is 6% over the previous year. The poultry meat actually, which is having this 4.06 million ton production, and growth is 7.8% over the previous year. And top five meat producing states in India are the Uttar Pradesh, the Maharashtra, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. And the wool production, this is another important component from the livestock sector, contributing a lot in the employment in the rural areas, in the hilly area, in the tribe area. And you know, the total wool production in the country is 40.42 million kgs. And there is a decline in the growth in the production of the wool from the previous year. There is a 2.5% decline in the production of wool in the country. And top five producing states of wool production are the Rajasthan, which is contributing around 36% of the wool production, then Jammu and Kashmir, which is contributing 19%, the Telangana, which is contributing 10%, the Karnataka, which is contributing these 7.6%, the Gujarat, contributing 5.6%. So these five states, basically they are contributing around 17.8.5% of the total wool production in the country. Now here the also see the population of the livestock in the country, and you know data is given in the million numbers, and you know all types of animals population is increasing in the country. Like you know cattle, we were having around 155 million cattle in the year 1950-51, which has increased to 192 million number of cattle in the year 2019. And then buffalo, we have increased from 43.4 million in the year 1950-51 to you know 109 million number of buffalo we have in the year 2019. So you know more than 2.5 times increase in the buffalo population in the country. And then total bovine we have was having the 198 million in the year in the year 1951, which has increased to 302 million number of the total bovine in the country. And the sheep population has also increased over the period of time. The goat population has also increased over the period of time. And total livestock population, which was 292.9 million number in the year 1950-51, which is increased to 535.8 million number in the year 2019. So there is a drastic change, you know, more than around two times increase in the livestock population in the last 60 years or 70 years, we can see. And the poultry number has also increased drastically, actually more than 10 times increase in the poultry number. Actually in the 1950-51 we were having 73 million number of the poultry in the country, which has increased to 851 million number of the poultry in the year 2019. So there is a drastic increase in the animal population in the country. And you know value of the output from the livestock sector is also increased over the period of time. You know from the milk group, the value of output was you know 3,27,000 in the year 2011-12, which has increased to 7,01,000 in the year 2017-18. And the meat group, the value of output of the meat group is was 96,219 crores in the year 2011-12, which has increased to 2,18,540 crores in the year 2017-18. And egg value of the egg, which was 16,633 crore rupees in the year 2011-12, which has increased to 32,844 crore rupees in the year 2017-18. So, you know, value of the output from the livestock sector was 4,87,751 crore rupees in the year 2011-12, which is increased to, you know, 10,43,656 crore rupees in the year 2017-18. So, in the last 6 years, we can see the increase in the value of the output from the livestock sector is more than 2.5 times. So there is a very good growth in the value of the output of the livestock sector over the period of time. And then contribution of the livestock in the gross value added in the agriculture sector. So here we can see the contribution of the crop sector in the total gross value added is 10%. The fishing sector, they are contributing 1.1%. The forestry is contributing 1.2%. Then the livestock sector is contributing around 4.9% in the total national gross value added. And the share of the livestock sector in the gross value added from the agriculture sector is 28.4% in the year 2017-18. And now we'll move to the sericulture sector. Sericulture is basically agro-based industry. It involves rearing of silkworm for the production of raw milk, and which is basically raw milk, basically a yarn obtained from the cocoon spoon by certain species. And the major activity in the production of sericulture or raw silk is the we need to cultivate the food plants to feed the silkworm, which spin the silk cocoon, and then reeling of the cocoon for unwinding the silk filament for the value added benefits such as the processing and weaving. And then the production of this is sericulture is, you know, basically we can see the data that we have the area and the mulberry plantation, which is 2,35,000 hectare, and mulberry cocoon production is 1,85,000,000 metric ton. And the raw silk production was, you know, 35 1468 metric ton in the country, and mulberry silk production is 25,000 metric ton, and the 1 year silk production is 10,000 metric ton, and export from the silk sector is, you know, around 2031.88 crores. So the employability, this sector, sericulture sector, is providing employment to 91.78 lakh person. Now we can sum up this session, and you know, there are various subsectors in the agriculture sectors, the livestock, horticulture, sericulture, poultry, fisheries. So there are various subsectors in the agriculture sector, and the horticulture and livestock are the very two important sectors which are contributing more than 50% of the total agricultural production, or you can say agriculture GDP. And so that's why there is a need to improve the condition of, there is a need to support these sectors, and we need to have policy support to develop the marketing, insurance and storage facility, because they are producing the perishable commodities. Then their nature is the perishable, their nature is the bulkiness. So we need to support the horticulture sector, the livestock sector actually, and we need to also motivate the farmers to diversify their crops towards the high value added, high value crops like the horticulture and also the animal rearing. So with this, I thank you all. Thank you very much.